Okay, so preparing to work with bacteria, first I spray the area that I'm going to work with 70% ethanol, very liberally. And then I use towels to wipe down. Just make sure everything's really clean. Dry for a second, because I definitely don't want to turn a flame on while there's ethanol around. While we're waiting for that, we can also take our LB. And I like to kind of wipe around the cap a little bit too. Residual stuff off, it's been autoclave. And then I get my serological pipettes ready. So we're gonna use the 25s. Okay. So now that the area is dry, I bring my Bunsen burner over. Sure, keep anything away, it might ignite, and I lower the flame. And the purpose of the flame is to make air currents go upwards, and so we're going to work closely around it. Okay, so this is our ampicillin, and so we're going to, for 1 liter, we're going to add 1 mL of the ampicillin stock. Close to the flame, without, of course, being careful to not burn myself. And I want to make sure that the ampicillin is distributed, so I'm going to shake. Somewhat quickly, because this is getting cool, it's going to solidify soon. So I open up the plates, I'm going to take all my plates out. Of the LB agar solution using my pipetter to each plate. And I'm going to work close to the flame and quickly as possible, and also keeping vessels open as short as possible. So I'm going to quickly open up the plate, pipette in without making too many bubbles. There are some, they'll go away on the side. Place it down. Go back. Opening close to the flame, slowly, and actually using one hand technique so that I don't put the cover on the surface, even though it's clean. I prefer not to. usually don't push all the way out to the end with the pipetter so that I don't get a big bubble at the end as a way to avoid it, so go as close as possible. But you see I'm working close to the flame. And minimizing the time that I keep the plate open. And then these will settle here on the bench for a period of time, and until they're solidified, at which point you turn them upside down and you put them back in the bag and put them in the cold room.